Despite the ever-growing Galaxy Watch Face ecosystem, you might very well be getting a little bit bored. And I don't blame you. Enter Watchmaker. Watchmaker is an app for the Galaxy Watch or any other smartwatch really. And today we're going to take a look at how to install it, how to use it, and some of the costs involved. Make sure you stay tuned, you might find this one helpful. What is up guys, welcome back to Tech It Easy. Today, we're gonna be taking a look at the Watchmaker app. So as I said, we're gonna go over how to install it, how to use it, and the costs involved. We'll also take a look at some of the pre-installed watch faces you get with the app. Just before we jump into the video though, if you could consider leaving a like and subscribing if you end up enjoying the video. Also, do consider joining the Discord community. It's a great way to get involved with the channel. I'm not gonna hold you up anymore. Let's get on with it. So as you might have guessed, the first step is to in fact install the application on your phone. So if you're using a Samsung device, you can actually get this from the Galaxy Store. Otherwise, you can head over to the Play Store or the Apple Store to download the app. There will be links down in the description, conveniently located very close to the subscribe button. You might as well. Now this is of course a free application. However, once it's downloaded, it will prompt you to download the companion app onto your watch, which unfortunately is a paid application. It only costs between £3 and £4, so it's not gonna break the bank, but actually there is some more costs involved and I will get to that later on in the video. Before you install the companion app, the application will ask you what sort of watch you've got, so just select which one you have from the list. Then it will take you to the companion app download page. Once the app has finished installing, you can head over to your smartwatch to check the Watchmaker app out. It has a very similar sort of UI to what Facer does. Facer is another free watch face app, and you can check out my top 10 Facer watch face video up in the top right corner now or after the video's finished. When using the Watchmaker app on your watch, you have a selection of pre-installed watch faces, which you can customize within the watch without the need for your phone. However, your phone goes into much more depth and detail and gives you a lot more customization options, which I'll show off shortly. Double tapping on the screen will bring up the customization options on your watch and also allow you to switch between the various different pre-installed watch faces. So let's head back over to Watchmaker on your phone. So again, it has a very similar layout and store to what Facer does. You have a selection of various different watch faces made by other people and actual designers, which you can download both free and paid versions. You can also edit the watch faces within the app, or you can even create your own. And this is where things get, I guess, a little bit disappointing. So I was trying to record customizing a watch face for you guys, and I kept getting this notification saying, pay for the pro version to unlock all customization features. However, there really wasn't any customization features available, and I felt it was a bit of a hidden cost, which wasn't really necessary. Nonetheless, because I love you all, I went and paid for it, so we can fully explore all the features of Watchmaker. And I have to say, it was kind of cool, even though it did take quite a while to get the hang of it. So if you're no stranger to Photoshop, it might be a little bit easier for you. It's basically a layer system where you just layer different elements on top of each other and you build your own watch face from scratch. You can even upload your own photographs and pick colors from photographs on your phone, which I thought was a pretty nice touch. One thing I will say is that when you're designing the watch face on your phone, things can look a little bit pixelated and, well, just a bit naff really, but honestly, once you get the watch face onto your watch, it looks a hell of a lot better, so there's nothing to worry about there. Okay, so let's jump into the Watchmaker itself. So to be honest, it's not quite as simple as it looks. There is a lot going on, but once you get the hang of it, it can become pretty easy. So to start off, just simply tap the plus button to choose an element. So you'll start off with your background, and then you can move on to your hour hand, your minute hand, and your second hand. You've got hundreds of different ones to choose from, but you are limited if you don't pay for the premium version, which is only $7.99 for a lifetime subscription. Just playing around with it quickly, it is really easy. After tapping the tick, after picking your element, it does sometimes take a while to sort of load up, but after that it's really nice and easy. You can add different elements such as battery gauges, steps counters, date and time, and even custom shapes and GIFs. You have an immense amount of control, so you can scale it up and down, move it left or right. You can do this by just moving it with your finger, or for more precision, you can use the controls at the bottom of the screen. There's honestly plenty to choose from, and it's actually not a quick task to do. You really do need to sit down for a while and have a good old look at this thing. So now we've got a good idea of how it looks, I'm going to show off what I managed to come up with about 15 to 20 minutes worth of playing about. So this is my watch face, which I managed to make. I'm sure you guys can do a hell of a lot better than I did, but I kept things pretty simple. I managed to get a nice theme going with the Techie Easy colors. And actually, when I put it on my watch, I was really surprised as to how good it looked. Personally, I've added a steps counter, the date off to the right, and then a battery gauge off to the left. I could even put something at the top if I really wanted to, such as moon phases. But really, I quite like the minimal aesthetic of the watch. Little tip for you, you can actually change the font and style of the text. I added a metal text to give it a bit of depth and a bit of shine. You can also add cool animations to it, as I'm showing off on screen now, but I don't think I'm gonna leave it like that. So finally, moving back to the app and the watch faces it has featured on it, there are actually some really nice realistic ones and some that we've not seen on the Galaxy Store or even on the likes of Facer before. And the best thing about these is that you can customize them all within the phone app or on the watch itself. You have hundreds of different color options, and again, you can also pick custom colors. The one I'm showing off now is probably one of my favorites. It's called the Zephron, and it comes in around $199. Definitely some great watch faces to explore, and personally, I'm thinking that I'm probably gonna do a dedicated video on the best watch faces on the Watchmaker app. Also, it'd be really nice if you could join the Discord server and share your own watch faces with each other that you've made. I do also believe that someone else has posted a link in the Discord channel with over 100 free different watch faces to download, so you should definitely go and check that out. Do remember, there will be download links for the Watchmaker app down below. So that is it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Do remember, if you did find the video helpful, please do leave a like and subscribe if you're new around here. For now though, this has been Tech It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.